Hi everyone, marhaba, this is Sharik and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. Today's lesson is going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson to my Lebanese Arabic students. We will be learning 34 sentences that have the word عين, eye in Arabic, or عيون, which is the plural of the word عين. I was actually trying to find out how many phrases or idioms we have, and I realized that we have so many of them. I never thought about it. I think it's because in Arabic culture they give so much importance to the eyes and the beauty of the eyes and how they believe that somebody's personality is reflected through their eyes. So maybe that's why we have so many of these sentences, and I was able to remember only 34 or 35 of them. So let's begin. Actually, before we begin, let me as usual ask you to subscribe to my channel if you find my lessons useful. Also follow me on Facebook and on Instagram. I try to upload lessons there on a daily basis as well. So if you follow me, this will encourage me to upload more and more lessons on a daily basis. Also, the phrases that we will be learning today, I will upload them on Instagram and on Facebook. I will leave the links in the description box down below. This way you can have the opportunity to see all the sentences and phrases together. You can take a snapshot of these and you can say them out loud, write them down, try to memorize them. And also, if you can, leave the homework in the description box down below. Let's begin. So the first expression will be تكرم عينك or تكرم عينك. So if you say merci or thank you or شكرًا to someone, the reply would be usually تكرم or تكرمي in Lebanese Arabic. But if you want to be warm and friendly, you say تكرم عينك if you're talking to a guy. And if you're talking to a woman, you will say تكرم عينك. And you can say it with this tonality, like friendly tonality. تكرم عينك or تكرم عينك. This literally means may your eye be honored. It's a way to say, of course I will do what you ask for, or you are welcome, you're very, very welcome actually. So, next time somebody tells you merci, or thank you, or shukran, you can reply and say tikram aynak, or tikram aynik. The second expression for today is عيونك الحلوين, or عيونك الحلوين. If you're talking to a guy, you will say عيونك الحلوين. And if you're talking to a girl, you will say عيونك الحلوين. When do we say this? When we receive a compliment. For example, if somebody tells me انت حلوة, you are beautiful, I can say merci, thank you, but I can also be very friendly and say عيونك الحلوين, your eyes are the ones that are beautiful. You know, it's like I'm saying your eyes are beautiful, that's why you see me as beautiful. So if I say to someone عيونك حلوين without the ال, عيونك حلوين, I'm just saying to him your eyes are beautiful. And if I say to a girl عيونك حلوين, your eyes are beautiful. But if I say عيونك الحلوين with the ال, it's like there's an emphasis there. I'm saying your eyes are the ones that are beautiful. And that's why if you want to reply to somebody telling you that you are beautiful or you look beautiful or something is beautiful, your clothes or something like that, you have to say عيونك الحلوين, not عيونك حلوين. Or عيونك الحلوين, not عيونك حلوين. The third one for today will be لعيونك. So, if somebody asks you for a favor, you can tell them لعيونك, for your eyes. It means, yes, I will do it for your eyes, لعيونك. And if it's a woman, you will say لعيونك. So the أك sound in the end is the possessive ending for the masculine form. So it's your, عيونك. And if it's feminine, it's عيونك. And remember, this is a word that has the عين sound, okay? Make sure to pronounce it really strongly. So don't say عيونك or عيونك. We never say it this way. We have to say عيونك, عيونك, or عيونك, عيونك, or عيونك. So if I want to say, of course, I'll do you that favor, I can say لعيونك. And if it's a woman, I will say لعيونك. There is another expression that means almost the same thing. We use it in Lebanon, but not so much. Maybe they use it more in Egypt, but it would be interesting to mention it. So they say, من هالعين قبل هالعين, and they actually say it by pointing the, their fingers to their eyes, so they say من هالعين, from this eye, قبل, before, قبل هالعين, before هالعين, this eye, from this eye, before this eye, من هالعين, قبل هالعين, من هالعين, قبل هالعين. It's a way to say, of course, I'll do you that favor. If somebody asks you for a favor, you can say لعيونك, or you can say من هالعين قبل هالعين. Another way to say, of course, I will do you this favor is على عيني, literally on my eye. على عيني. Sometimes we say على راسي, on my head, which means yes, of course, I will do you this favor, or I am at your service, or something like that. على عيني أو على راسي. In Syria, for example, they would pronounce it على عيني. In Egypt, they would also pronounce it على عيني. In Lebanon, we would pronounce it على عيني, on my eye. Okay, the next expression is على عينك يا تاجر. على, on, عينك, your eye, يا تاجر, على عينك يا تاجر. And it doesn't change على عينك or على عينك. It's a fixed expression. على عينك يا تاجر. على, on, عينك, your eye, يا تاجر. تاجر means businessman or tradesman. And when we use the word يا before it, it's like a way to say like, hey businessman or hey tradesman. It's not informal, by the way. You can say it to anyone, to any person, your friends or people in the street, or to the queen even. It's not informal, okay? So على عينك يا تاجر. It's a way to address yourself to people, basically, the word يا تاجر. When I say على عينك يا تاجر, I mean that the person in front of me or somebody else we're talking about is so shameless, they make a mistake even in your face and they don't even care. So it's like they're not embarrassed or they're not ashamed, and they're doing something very, very rude and openly and without even feeling ashamed of themselves. So that's when I say على عينك يا تاجر. For example, if you have been going out with someone and then you realize one of your friends is going out with them, and then you broke up, and then the next day you see your friend going out with them and they don't even care about you, you say, like, you can, it's the perfect scenario to say على عينك يا تاجر, which means they don't even care what they're doing. The next expression will be القرد بعين أمه غزال. القرد, القرد, قرد means monkey. القرد بعين, ب means in, عين, eye, أمه, أم means mother, أمه means his mother. القرد بعين أمه غزال. غزال means gazelle. القرد بعين أمه غزال means the monkey is a gazelle is in his mother's eyes, which means no matter how somebody's baby is not good looking or maybe even not nice or not fun, their mother always sees them the best no matter what they do. Or it doesn't always have to be only about mothers towards their children. Say for example, I'm going out with someone again and he's really, really not good looking at all, and I always think that, oh my god, he's the most handsome guy in the world, and I keep talking about him. Maybe one of my friends would say القرد بعين أمه غزال, which means I only think he's beautiful just because I love him. The next expression for today will be ما إلي عين. ما إلي عين. ما means I don't, إلي have, عين eye. I don't have an eye. ما إلي عين. ما إلي عين. When can you use this? It's an expression we use to say that we are embarrassed or shy about doing something, or we don't want to say something to somebody else just so that we don't annoy them or upset them or embarrass ourselves. When can I use this? For example, if I'm in a shop and I'm buying clothes and I want to ask for a good price and bargain, maybe my friend tells me, go ahead and tell him to reduce the price. I go like, ما إلي عين, like I'm a bit embarrassed to do it. Now, sometimes when somebody does something again that is a bit maybe rude or something they shouldn't be doing, I can ask them this expression as a question. I can say, كيف إلك عين? كيف means how, إلك, do you have, إلك, إلي means I have, إلك is you have. كيف إلك عين? How do you have an eye? And if I'm talking to a girl, I say كيف إلك عين? So for example, if somebody makes the same mistake every time, for example, and maybe one day I make one little mistake and they come and blame me and all of that, I can say كيف إلك عين? Or كيف إلك عين? And sometimes we can use the same expression with the verb تحكي. So I can say كيف إلك عين تحكي? تحكي means you talk. كيف إلك عين تحكي? How do you have an eye to talk? Or كيف إلك عين تحكي? How do you have an eye to talk? Which means how dare you? Or how dare you? Or how can you say this when you shouldn't be saying it, basically. Okay? And then sometimes the reply for this, if we really believe that we're not doing anything wrong, I can say إلي عينتين كمان. إلي, I have, عينتين, عين, one eye, عينتين, two eyes. إلي عينتين كمان. I also have two eyes, not even just one eye, كيف إلك عين. If somebody tells me كيف إلك عين, I will say إلي عينتين كمان, which means yes, I will do it and I don't care and I'm right. إلي عينتين كمان. We have the expression عينو ضيقة. عينو, his eye, ضيقة, ضيقة, ضيق. Is the adjective tight. For example, t-shirt ضيق. When I say his eye is tight, عينه ضيقة, or if it's feminine, I would say عينه, her eye, عينه ضيقة. It's when somebody is, how can I say this? It's like they are maybe materialistic, or they just like, I don't know, if they see someone who has a nice car, they are just somebody who's basically materialistic and not the opposite of this expression, by the way, is عينو شبعاني. عينو, his eye, شبعاني is literally, the word شبعاني means satiated, full, his eye is full. You know, when you're eating, you say أنا شبعاني, I am full. عينو شبعاني, literally his eye is full, which means a person who doesn't really care about material stuff, or it, like, they're not just interested in people just because they are wearing brand names or whatever, they're just interested in carrying a Gucci bag or whatever. That's عينو ضيقة. The opposite is عينو شبعاني. If it's feminine, we will say عينه شبعاني. By the way, something I didn't mention, the word عين is one of the exceptional words that don't have a ت مربوطة in Arabic, but it's a feminine word, عين. That's why we are saying عينه شبعاني, the eye is satiated. And because the word eye is feminine, I'm saying شبعاني, I'm not saying شبعان. So عينه شبعاني, عينه شبعاني, somebody who is, I don't know, they have this nice character of, you know, having a nice personality and not caring about, you know, the superficial stuff. When I say عينو ضيقة, it means he's superficial, and when I say عينو شبعاني, it means they are not superficial. And by the way, عينو فارغة is exactly the same as عينو ضيقة. فارغ, the masculine form of the adjective, means empty in Arabic, فارغ. And عينو فارغة, his eye is empty. So it's the same thing, عينو ضيقة or عينو فارغة. And if it's feminine, you will say عينه ضيقة or عينه فارغة. فارغة. So it's a bit difficult to pronounce this word. So you have to pronounce the R and the R. فارغ and فارغة. Now, from the expression عينه ضيقة, we can move to a similar expression, but this time used as a verb. So for example, we say sometimes ضيقت بعينه. ضيقت بعينه, ضيقت بعينه, if it's feminine. And if I'm talking to a guy directly, I'm saying you, I can say ضيقت بعينك. And if I'm talking to a girl, I can say ضيقت بعينك. And sometimes I can ask it as a question, ضيقت بعينك, or ضيقت بعينك, with this tonality, ضيقت بعينك. It's a fun expression, actually, to say. Sometimes it's fun, sometimes it's not fun when we are serious, but when we're not serious and we're saying it as a joke, we say ضيقت بعينك. When can I say this? If, for example, somebody has so many things, really a lot of things, and then they really just focus on that one thing that you have and they want it. Maybe I'm eating a hamburger, a little hamburger, and somebody else is eating so many hamburgers, and pizzas and chickens and all of that. And they tell me, oh, but you're eating a hamburger, you know? So it's like they're focusing on that one thing that you're doing, and they want it, or they want to do it, or they want to make you feel bad about doing it. Another expression would be عيني فيك, my eyes in you. عيني فيها, my eyes in her. Literally فيك, in you. فيها, in her. وعيني في, my eye is in him. So فيك, in you. فيها, in her. And في, in him. عيني فيك, عيني فيها, or عيني في. So we can say it to a person. If I really like someone, I can tell my friend that عيني في is like my eyes in him. But it also applies to that food scenario that I told you about. For example, if I'm eating food and I'm looking at my friend's food and I really feel like having a piece of that food, and you know, in that case, he can tell me, عينيك, your eye, عينيك فيها, your eye is in it. So for example, if they give me the piece and I say, no, I don't want, لا ما بدي, they can say, no, really take it because your eye is in it. It's like I'm gonna choke if you keep looking at it. So in that case, my friend can tell me, عينيك فيها, your eye is in it, or عينيك بالأكل, your eye is in the food. Let's move to some romantic expressions. So, when we say to someone انت or انت, انت if it's a guy, انت if it's a girl, انت نور عيوني, you are the light of my eyes. انت نور عيوني. Sometimes we also say انت نور عيني, and in Egypt they would pronounce it عيني rather than عيني. نور عيوني or نور عيني, you are the light of my eyes. And sometimes if we really love someone so much, I can say بعطيك عيوني. بعطيك, I give you, if I'm talking to a guy. And بعطيك, if I'm talking to a girl. بعطيك عيوني, I give you my eyes. I love you so much that I can give you my eyes. We use the same one for heart. بعطيك قلبي, I give you my heart. Or بعطيك قلبي. Okay, so what would you say to someone if you're disappointed with them? If you used to think that they're really so nice, such a good person, and suddenly you realize that they're not nice, you can say وطيت بعيني. That's masculine. وطيت بعيني. وطيت literally means you lowered. وطيت, you lowered بعيني, in my eyes. It's like you had a high place in my eyes and suddenly in my eyes you are lower. وطيت بعيني, if I'm talking to a guy. And if I'm talking to a girl, I say وطيت بعيني. وطيت بعيني. That's not usually a fun expression, it's a serious expression. And sometimes, even if you don't mean it, if you're upset with the person you love, and in Arabic culture, when they tend to emotionally blackmail someone, they say وطيت بعيني, وطيت بعيني, and the other person would feel really, really bad. Now, if you're embarrassed because of something, and or maybe because you made a mistake, you put your eyes on the floor, literally, you look at the floor, right? In Arabic, we literally say he put his eyes on the floor. If I want to say he put his eyes on the floor, I say حط, he put, حط, he placed, or he put. حط عيونه, his eyes, بالأرض, literally in the floor or in the ground. حط عيونه بالأرض. And if it's a lady who did it, she was embarrassed or really shy about something that she did, and really she wants to hide herself, that's why she puts her eyes into the ground or in the floor, we say حطت. So حط is masculine, حطت is feminine. حطت عيونه بالأرض. She put her eyes into the ground or into the floor. And if we want to say it to someone, like we want to tell them, just feel embarrassed about what you did and don't even look at me anymore, I can say to a guy, حط عيونك بالأرض. So حط, put, عيونك, your eyes, حط عيونك بالأرض. Or in the feminine form, حط عيونك بالأرض. حط عيونك بالأرض. حتى عيونك بالأرض. I don't like this expression because it's a bit patronizing. Sometimes this is also an expression that is used to show that somebody has a higher rank or position. So it reflects hierarchy. For example, I don't know, maybe if you're in the police station and you're not allowed to talk or something like that, they tell you put your eyes into the floor. حتى عيونك بالأرض. And if it's masculine, if it's feminine, you will say حتى عيونك بالأرض. It means you're not good enough to look at me or to look into my eyes or something like that. So it's also a way, it's like you're showing respect to somebody else. That's why you put your eyes into the floor and basically you avoid eye contact. Now, the opposite of this expression is حتى عينك بعيني. Put your eye in my eye. حتى عينك. حتى masculine. حتى feminine. حتى عينك, your eye. Be in عيني, my eye. So عينك, your eye. عيني, my eyes. حط عينك بعيني. And if it's feminine, I say حط feminine عينيك. Okay, so عينك is masculine, عينيك is feminine. حط عينك بعيني. It's an expression that can be used in two different scenarios. One, to say to someone that, you know, tell me the truth or something. Look into my eyes and tell me. Look into my eyes and tell me that you don't love me, for example. So حط عينك بعيني وقل لي إنه ما بتحبني and tell me that you don't love me. And if you're talking to a lady, you can say وقلي لي إنك ما بتحبيني. So قلي لي إنه ما بتحبيني. Tell me that you don't love me. It's an expression you use to face someone. So, and if you want them to tell you the truth, حط عينك بعيني. And sometimes we use it just to say, just look into my eye, or maybe to connect to someone. You can say حط عينك بعيني or حط عينك بعيني. Okay, so it's an expression that is used to ask for the truth or honesty or maybe some intimacy. And do you know that eye stalk? I don't know if there's this expression in English, but we say in Arabic عيونه بيحكو. عيونه, his eyes, بيحكو, they talk. And if it's a woman, you will say عيونه بيحكو, her eyes talk, which means somebody who has this really strong charisma, or maybe if they look at you, they really influence you or something, or whatever they think of, it's in their eyes and it's clear. They have clear eyes and their eyes speak. It means they have so much honesty in their eyes. So عيونه بيحكو or عيونه بيحكو. I can also say عيوني بيحكو, my eyes talk. If somebody asks me a question, I can say عيوني بيحكو. If somebody asks me if I love them, I can say عيوني بيحكو, my eyes speak it. I don't have to say it, basically. Another expression would be مشيل عيونه عني. مشيل, شيل, he removed. مشيل, he didn't remove. مشيل عيونه, he didn't remove his eyes. عني, which means from me. مشيل عيونه عني, he literally didn't remove his eyes from me. And if it's feminine, you say مشيلت, she didn't remove. مشيلت عيونا عني, she didn't remove her eyes from me. When can you use this? If you go to a place and somebody keeps looking and looking and looking at you and they're not even turning away, that's when you say مشيل عيونه عني or مشيلت عيونه عني. It can be for different reasons. Maybe because they're attracted to us, or maybe because, for example, I don't know, they're trying to find out something about us. We say مشيل عيونه عني or مشيلت عيونه عني. We also say somebody's eyes are like a cow, like cow's eyes when they have really big and beautiful eyes. So we can say عيونك حلوين, your eyes are beautiful, مثل عيون البقرة, like the eyes of a cow, مثل عيون البقرة, or عيونك حلوين مثل عيون البقرة. I don't know how common is this. Maybe it's a bit old school or something they use in the villages. I grew up in a village and I heard people saying it. So it's probably less common now, but it's still used. So, عيونك حلوين, your eyes are beautiful, مثل عيون البقرة, like the eyes of a cow. And if it's masculine, you will say عيونك حلوين, your eyes are beautiful, مثل عيون البقرة, مثل, like, عيون, the eyes, البقرة, the cow. But pronounced together with the liaison, مثل عيون البقرة. Let's talk about the evil eye. If somebody hit us the evil eye, we say صابني بالعين. صابني بالعين. He hit me with his eye. And it's not literally to hit someone. It's not that hitting صابني. It's, for example, if you are targeting something, maybe with a gun or something, and you hit your target, that kind of hitting. So that's صابني بالعين. And صابتني, if it's feminine, she hit me with the evil eye. صابتني بالعين, صابني بالعين, صابتني بالعين. Sometimes we use it really in the real meaning of the word, and sometimes we use it as a joke. I don't know, maybe I'm walking and my friend keeps looking at me, or my sister keeps looking at me, and suddenly I trip. I can say as a joke, صابتني بالعين, she gave me the evil eye or something. Okay, and I can also say you hit me with the evil eye. I can say subtne, 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 pronounced very fast as subtne bilayn, almost like the T is disappearing. Subtne bilayn, you hit me with the evil eye. And if it's feminine, you will say subtine bilayn, subtine, subtine bilayn. And the action of hitting with the evil eye is صيبت عين. So صيبة is the noun of صاب or صابت. We say صيبة, صيبت عين, the action of hitting with the evil eye. I don't know, for example, if I was very happy and I went to a vacation and I was so happy and I looked really glamorous and beautiful and danced all night and at the end maybe I fell and I broke my leg or something, people can say to me, "Ah, صيبت عين, it's an evil eye, صيبت عين." We have some curses as well, like not really 100% swear words, but like curses, maybe let's call them curses. So if somebody is doing something really bad, I can say لعمة بعيونك. Okay, so لعمة بعيونك. العمى, the blindness, بعيونك, in your eyes. And if it's a lady, I will say العمى بعيونك. So I'm not pronouncing العمى بعيونك, I'm pronouncing it just العمى بعيونك, العمى بعيونك, or العمى بعيونك, which means may blindness be in your eyes or something like that. When somebody does something really bad, or even when somebody hits us, gives us the evil eye, we can say العمى بعيونك or العمى بعيونك. We can use this sometimes as a joke as well, so it's not always too serious. Maybe sometimes when you're driving and you're really angry with someone who was, I don't know, driving like crazy or something, you can say العمى بعيونك. And actually, we have the same curse, but instead of عيون, we use it with the heart. العمى بقلبك. Makes me laugh when I say this. العمى بقلبك. If it's a guy, or العمى بقلبك. We use it a lot in Lebanese Arabic. If you're Lebanese, you need to get used also to using swear words and cursing, because we do it a lot. So العمى بعيونك, العمى بعيونك, or العمى بقلبك, and العمى بقلبك. And if I want to ask someone if they believe in the evil eye, I say, do you believe in the eye? Just like that. بتأمن, بتأمن, do you believe? بتأمن بالعين, بالعين, in the, بال, in the, عين. Do you believe in the eye? بتأمن بالعين. And if it's a lady, I will ask her, بتأمن بالعين, بتأمن بالعين. And I could say, إيه أو لا, yes or no. Now there's this expression that it's not so commonly used in a spoken way, like we don't commonly speak it in Lebanese Arabic, but you might see it in those, you know, trucks or cars that have like a hanging shoe and they have this written sentence on their car. It's more like a ghetto kind of sentence that we usually see in Lebanon. It's probably much more common to use in other Arabic countries, and maybe it's not ghetto to use, but in Lebanon, usually when it's used, it's written behind the car or something like that. So this expression is عين الحسود تبلى بالعمى. Let me repeat it. عين الحسود, the eye, عين الحسود of the envious person. حسود means the person who envies. عين الحسود تبلى بالعمى. بالعمى means in the, and عمى means blindness. Okay, so عين الحسود تبلى بالعمى, which means may the eye of the envious person become blind, basically. عين الحسود تبلى بالعمى. Okay, we have three more. The next one is يا عيني عليك. Ya عيني, you know when I said ya, which means I'm addressing myself to someone, ya عيني, it's like you're saying oh my eye. Ya عيني, عين, عيني, my eye. Ya عيني عليك, on you, oh my eye on you. Literally it means that, but we actually don't mean that at all. Ya عيني عليك, when I use it to say well done or like good job to someone. Ya عيني عليك. Or I also use it, maybe I wasn't sure about something and I was asking, who's that person? How do I know that? Or whatever. And then suddenly the person guesses and I go like, eh, يا عيني عليك, يا عيني عليك, like my eye on you, which means like well done or 100% you remembered it. Sometimes when I use يا عين, just like that, يا عين, and I open my eyes like that, it's like I'm being sarcastic or I'm not approving of a situation that's happening or of something that someone is doing. I can say يا عين like that and I can maybe move my head, يا عين, which means awesome or great, but I of course mean the opposite. But some people do say يا عين, يا عيني, you know, when they are in a state of really happiness or trance. Or actually mostly this sentence is used with something called tarab. Tarab is like very traditional and old Arabic music that was very famous in the medieval period and within the Ottoman Empire, and actually it's still going on nowadays. People sing it, and when they sing it they have to have really very good skills. That's tarab. And in tarab songs, when they sing it, they really feel it and they're like in a trance of happiness and in a state of happiness and trance. They go like ya ayn ya lil. Okay, so they even put their hand here and they go ya ayn ya lil. We even have another Lebanese song that goes Habibi ya ayni, or my Habibi is my love, my eye. Habibi ya ayni, my love, my eyes. So it's really, really used. If you are singing or dancing, you're in an Arabic party and you go ya ayni, even if you don't know what you're saying and in what context, it will be right to use, because we use this sentence a lot when we're in a party or when we're having fun, when we're dancing, when we're singing. You can just say ya ayn or ya ayne, oh I or oh my eyes, ya ayne. And you can even say ya ayne ya layli, ya layli, pronounced as ya layli, oh my night, oh my eye, oh my night, ya layli. So you can say that. The final expression, I feel a bit bad to say this because it feels like I'm making fun, but I'm not. It's an expression that some people do use it in Lebanese Arabic, and just really, really, it's a joke, just unique to Lebanese people, not used in other Arabic countries. When somebody is cross-eyed, we say to him, or not in his face, but sometimes as a joke, somebody says about that person, عين فيه, an eye in me, وعين بالأشرفية, and an eye in أشرفية. أشرفية is simply an area in Lebanon. It's a posh area in Lebanon, أشرفية. And we just use them together because they rhyme. عين فيه وعين بالأشرفية, an eye in me and an eye in أشرفية, which means the person is cross-eyed, so they look at me, one eye is on me, but the other eye is in that area of أشرفية. Maybe you can also use it when somebody is drunk or high or something and they're not able to focus. So you can say عين فيه وعين بالأشرفية. That's it, and I hope you enjoyed it. I really, really hope you enjoyed it. Hope to see you soon in one of my lessons. And again, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, because I will be uploading all these sentences as a list there, and also on Facebook. Simply type at Globetrot with Arabic and you will find me. Thank you very much. Merci كتير. شكرا. ومع السلامة. Actually, also before I go, let me ask you to at least choose your favorite 5 or 10 of these sentences and expressions and leave them in the comment box below. Also, if you know any expression that I forgot to include or mention, you can also put it in the description box below. Also, if you use it in your language, if there's an expression in your language that you use in relation to the eyes, you can also put it in the comment box below. That's it for today. Thank you very much. Merci كتير ومع السلامة. يلا باي باي. Guess what, guys? I just remembered another one and I already dismantled the studio behind me, but I really wanted to say it to you. It's funny. The expression عيني في, remember when I said it to you, عيني في? عيني فيك as well, my eyes in you, but there's an expression that goes عيني في وتفو علي. تفو علي is like, you know, when you say تفو عليك or تفو علي, it's like you, تفو is just a sound to express that you're spitting on someone because like he's disgusting or something, you don't like what he's doing. Sometimes you use it as a joke, sometimes in real life. So when you say عيني فيك وتفو عليك, my eye is in you, but at the same time تفو عليك, like I spit on you, which means I want you and I don't want you at the same time. It's like you don't want someone but you really want them. عيني فيك وتفو عليك. See you.